Good evening. Welcome. I'm Sylvia Johns-Ritchie, and I'm so excited and proud to have my friend of mine with me tonight, who is also a three-time Grammy-nominated CBMA Cammy Award-winning producer, engineer, guitarist, and vocalist. And he also owns Cape Fear Studios and Cape Fear Records here in Wilmington. And his name is J.K. Lofton. Hi, J.K.
Hi.
Nice to have you with us tonight. And we'll tell you a little more about J.K. in a little while, but I have to tell you that because of J.K., I have a beach music career, and I'll tell you all about that later. But anyway, but I don't want his head to get too big. But anyway, we got a great show lined up for you guys tonight, and we hope y'all will put on your dancing shoes, snap your fingers, whatever, just clap your hands, have a good time, because we're just trying to uplift you guys with some music, and we hope that this will make you happy tonight. And that's what we want to do, make people happy with our music, right, J.K.?
Absolutely.
Yeah, definitely. But anyway, we're going to open up the show tonight with a song that has been really, really good for me, good to me, and it was produced by J.K. Lofton, and it's from his latest compilation CD, which is called Cape Fear Beach Sessions, Volume 1. And the song is called Two More Bottles of Wine, and I recorded it with Dan Thomas from Smokin' Hot, which is a wonderful beach music band. And Dan and I have been so surprised at how well this song has done, the success of it, and it's still on the charts. And by the way, thank you for voting for it, and if you don't mind, keep on voting, okay? Yes, definitely. But anyway, here is our song that was number one almost 6 weeks in a row, Two More Bottles of Wine. Is one the first song that I recorded with J.K. actually, and it was from my album that I did in 2018, and this title song of the album was Some Girls Have It All, and this actually goes out to Amber. She likes this song, and I did it with J.K. at his studio, and he said, if you change the beat on that song, that could be a beach music smoothie. And I was like, a what? And he said, a smoothie. And I said, well, I thought a smoothie was a drink from Dairy Queen. But it's like, I found out it wasn't a dance. I mean, it was a dance. It wasn't a drink. Yeah, exactly. It's a slowed down version of the shag, which is the dance of North and South Carolina, of course. But anyway, so I was so excited that I had written a song that was a beach music smoothie. And the song is called Some Girls Have It All. And JK helped me so much on this song. And this won me one of my first Cammies, which is back here on the shelf behind me. It was on the compilation CD of the year from Carolina Beach Music Awards. And I'm really proud of that. Here is Some Girls Have It All. She likes that song. And I told you a little bit about our guest tonight earlier in the presentation, but I didn't give you any details really, but this JK has done so many things. He's played with so many great bands. He's been with Heart and Soul for like 14 years. The Craig Woolard Band, he helped start that, and he was with them for 4 years. And he was also with Mark Robertson Breeze for 3 years. Smoking Hot, the band we just talked about, the drummer who I recorded with for 4 years. And he's currently with Steve Owens in Summertime, which is, it's been with him 3.5 years. And I mean, I don't know when you find the time to do all this stuff, JK, but anyway. Also, he runs a wonderful studio, so if you want to record a song, he's the guy you need to talk to. He also has done 36 albums that he actually helped produce with Judy Collins. They were compilation albums, were they not, JK?
With like upwards of 15 different artists in
yes.
each one. And it was always really neat because every song would be completely different. But having Judy Collins, who probably knew as much or more about beach music than anybody around. I mean, she ran the record store. She had 3 different record labels, and she used Jay Spell as her music producer on the first 8 albums I worked on with her. And Jay worked with everybody from John Mayall, who Eric Clapton used to play with, to the Tractors, to Reba McEntire, to go to allmusic.com and type in the name Jay Spell and it'll blow your mind. He was with the Tower of Power,
yeah.
All sorts of people. I learned so much from those two people about the kind of thing that I seem to be doing the most of these days. And that's how I kind of, you know, helped Sylvia come to the attention of so many of you, because she came to me with an album that she had done or started on and was unable to finish because the person that started with her got another job and had to move away. And she said, well, can you help me? And we got through it. And when we got through with it, I said, you know, this song, the one we just did, really might do something here. And it did. And it worked out. And it was so funny. After she had done that, a couple of months later, she came over to my studio and walked in the door and said, I have written 3 beach music songs. I want you to hear them. Well, the very first one she played for me was a song called Carolina Moon, which we're not doing today. But it ended up being the title song on my next album. And she had great success with that. It ended up being a number one song in beach music. And so for somebody to have found out about it, and let's set things straight. She's a North Carolina girl. She knew about beach music, but she had been gone to Louisiana and Nashville and New York City and all sorts of other places in between for many, many years in between, and she just really wasn't that familiar.
I just made my way back.
But she's so good at what she does. All she has to do is think, okay, this is the way I need to aim my arrow when I'm shooting at my target. And she does pretty good at it. What you think?
Well, thank you, JK. I appreciate that. That is wonderful. I don't know. I have the big head. I don't know if I can play any more piano tonight. But anyway,
give me a break.
You know, you mentioned Eric Clapton a while ago, and you do this song of Eric Clapton so well. I really would like people to hear. And plus, if you guys out there want to get close and dance with your sweetie, this would be the time to do it, because he's going to do a great song that's one of my favorites. Called Wonderful Tonight.
And I'm going to start playing some chords, and Sylvie's going to fall in with me.
Yeah.
Thank you. turns to see this beautiful lady is walking around with me, and then she asked me, do you feel alright? And I say yes, I feel wonderful tonight. You just don't realize how much I love you.
That he always does with Steve Owens in Summertime, and I always like that part of the show when he does it. And so anyway, we're going to try to duplicate a little bit of that with a little song called Sick and Tired. And
I'm really, really lucky.
Let's see
if
we can get our drummer to do that for us, too.
I'm really, really lucky because I got Sylvia Ritchie with me, and she lived down in Louisiana where this song is from. She knows how to do it right. Here we go. Yeah, Fats Domino did this one back in the day. Oh, baby, what you doing?
telling you to change your way, telling you that I mean what I say, telling you you got to stop that jive, or you're gonna go on outside. Oh, baby, what you gonna do?
That we're going to do. By the way, I need to give a shout out to some of the people that are watching tonight. Some of my friends that I know will be watching. Doyle and Judy Wood will be watching. And let's see. Lynn O'Quinn will be watching tonight. That's so nice to have you guys with us. And I know if I try to name anybody, I will forget someone. But all you guys out there, we really appreciate you tuning in. And thank you so much for supporting our Home Alone concerts.
And we'd like to send some love back to your family in South Carolina.
My family in South Carolina goes up to my sister who lost her husband this past weekend. And I wish I could be there with them, but my heart is with them. So, and I want to thank Evan for doing our production tonight. So, as usual, he's behind the camera, but he does a great job for us, and thank you so much.
Yeah, I haven't gone anywhere, just working, focusing a little more on work and a little less on music for right now. So.
That's right, yeah. Yeah, they need him at his job more than I can have him here, but anyway. But we're so glad to have him with us tonight. The next song that JK's going to do for you is a song that was recorded by James Taylor, but it was also, to me, I like the Marvin Gaye. Is it Marvin Gaye?
Marvin wrote the song.
Yeah, yeah. I like his version because it's a little more danceable to me, a little more up-tempo. But the song is called How Sweet It Is. And let's see, is our drummer all ready?
Our drummer should be ready to go.
Okay, great. Well, let me see if the piano's ready. I think it's ready, too. Are you ready on the guitar back there?
Here we go.
It sounds like he is.
Sweet is to be loved by you. Get your dancing shoes on. How sweet is to be loved by you. I need the shadow.
Songs. The song is called Loving My Blues Away, and this song was also on my Some Girls Have It All CD, and it won me my second Cammy. It was from compilation CD of the year, I Count the Tears by Patman and Robin Records, and thank you guys for including my song Loving My Blues Away, and we hope you guys enjoy Loving My Blues. I hope you've got somebody in your life that can love your blues away. Talking about you, such a song to sing. Oh, baby. lot of fun to play too, isn't it?
I think I'm going to take a break right now. Is that okay with you?
Yeah.
I'm going to let you work a little harder.
Oh, okay. I was telling JK he could take a break after this song if he'd like to. Thank you so much, JK, but don't go away because we're going to need you back right after this Broadway segment.
I won't go far.
Okay. Thank you. Great. Thank you so much. Right now, I want to do, well, we try to do different genres of music on the program, and this is what we call our Broadway segment. And I want to do a special tribute to a show that opened in 1957 on Broadway. And the story is set in the Upper West Side of New York City. And it's a story of two teenage rival gangs, the Jets and the Sharks. The Jets are of Caucasian descent. The Sharks are Puerto Rican descent. And so a young lady by the name of Maria, whose brother is the head of the Puerto Rican Sharks, falls in love with Tony, who is a friend of the leader of the Jets. And you can see there's going to be a problem there. It's like the Romeo and Juliet kind of take, star-crossed lovers. And the music from this musical actually was made, they made a movie of this, and it actually won a Billboard Magazine Award for in 1962, after the movie came out in 1961. It also won an Academy Award, it won a Golden Globe, and it won numerous Tonys. And the music is wonderful. Music was written by Leonard Bernstein, and the lyrics, of course, were written by Stephen Sondheim. And the songs are so energetic and wonderful. The costumes were wonderful. If you ever get a chance to see it, you would really love it. But I'm going to get y'all to help me a little bit with the intro of this song, because I'm going to need some finger snaps, and my fingers are going to be busy, so I won't have time to be able to snap. But if you guys would help me out, we're going to do like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Y'all are doing great. 8.
Thank you.
songs of West Side Story.
All right.
Did I cover? I think I covered them all, didn't I?
If you didn't, I don't think anybody would know. You got them all.
Messed up my hair, too. We're going to bring J.K. back on one more time to do a song that I just finished writing a little while ago about heaven. And this is a song called After This. And I hope you guys will enjoy my song that that I wrote. And if I can get JK to join me, are you back with me? Okay, here we go.
Ready?
Is the drummer ready?
Everybody's ready. Here we go.
Thank you so much, J.K. Lofton. Wonderful. Mm-hmm. I enjoyed having you play with me. Evan Lucas, thank you, darling, for so much. You were so helpful, and we couldn't do the show without Evan, I tell you. He is wonderful. And
we couldn't do it without our fans, your fans that are watching
that
every
true.
Week. So thank
Definitely.
Them, too.
Thank you so much, guys, for tuning in. And we hope we brightened your day just a little bit. And don't forget, remember the little things in life. You know, this what we've been through has made me realize that I'm so thankful for little things in life that I never even noticed before. But I'm so happy that to tell you that if you look at the little things, it will pick you up and help your spirits a lot. And just remember that this too shall pass. And JK, will you help me out on our final song called Little Things of Life?
I just think that it's the coolest thing in the world that you decided to do this a few months ago when all of us were wishing we could communicate and interact with the people that have always come to see us doing what it is that we love to do. You got probably one of the best cases of what I call the can't help it's. That means if you don't do this, something is wrong in the world. And so you got the can't help it. You can't help but do this in order to feel like a complete human being. And the fact that you have people that will watch and enjoy and appreciate what you do. You give them something each week and they give you something back. They give you the reason to do it, because there's so much about what's going on now that's keeping us from being able to do that and enjoying what it is that we have been doing our whole lives. This is what I've done since I was 13 years old. This is the only job that I've
since
ever
I was
had
five.
Is making music. Yeah. And for Sylvia to have started doing this of her own volition, to decide that she wanted to share what it is that is the essence of her, regardless of what's going on, I think it's a blessing to all of us. And thank y'all for turning in, because if you hadn't continued to, I wouldn't even be here today.
thank you
so much.
Okay, here you go. Are you ready? The flag as it waves, say hello to our neighbors, see the kids run and play. We'll marvel at the beauty of another summer day. See the splendor of a sunset as the light just fades away. Hey!